doing hair for over 26 years. I'm 27 years old. And we're going to do a couple of things today. And those couple of things is not only am I going to introduce you to Chlorion and what it does, I'm going to give you a little bit of theory so that we can understand what it is that we can do with all of these beautiful colors, okay? First thing first, why Chlorion? And I'll go into the Lumetrix also. Why Chlorion? Number one, Chlorion Prestige is 100% made in Italy. Big deal. What does that mean? Yeah. The ingredients in it are going to be 100 times more better. For example, the water alone is excellent. Okay? So in the production and the pigments that you get are very rich and they last a long time. Number two, this is going to cover 100% of the grays. Okay? So if you're working with clients that have very much gray hair, this will cover 100% of the grays. Now, what does that mean? I always say that not color covers gray, you cover gray. If there's anything missing with the color, it's your fault, not the color's fault. You have to know how to drive the car in order for you to use it, okay? Now, the great thing about Chlorion is that anything over 25% gray, you're going to use 1-to-1 ratio, okay? So the color is used 1-to-1.5. So you're getting a tube that's more than 3 ounces, not 3 ounces like everybody else. So you're getting actually more color. The more color, you can do an extra client. An extra client means extra what?
Money.
No, that's right. So those are that's the another benefit for it, okay? Number two, it uses 1-to-1.5. So our ratio, 1 part of the color, 1.5 parts of peroxide. If you're using red, it's going to be 1 and 1. If you're using grays, anything over 25% gray, money, you're gonna use also 1-to-1. Now, if you're getting maybe 50%, 75% gray, I would tell you to use a little bit of the natural, whatever your target level is. If your target level is 6, level 6, right, 1 through 10, your levels. If your level is, your target level is level 6, you'll put a little bit of 6 in. If your target level is 7, if your target level is 8, so on and so forth, and we'll speak about the level system and how to read the colors. So far, so good? Number three, this is a progressive color, not aggressive color. Progresivo y no agresivo, right? Progressive means, right, that as you put the color on the hair, that color begins to work immediately, okay? It's going to lift and deposit at the same time. So you're already getting color that is being deposited. An aggressive color, which is a lot of the majority of colors out there, is that when you put the color in the hair, the peroxide works first. So the peroxide has to lighten the hair, and then 6-7 minutes later, then the color begins to deposit. Not with Prestige. Prestige, it automatically, as it's processing, it's depositing the color at the same time. So what does that mean? More pigment, more deposit, longer lasting, okay? Another thing is that it has coenzyme Q10. Coenzyme Q10 is anti-age, and what that's going to do is, for those hair that has lost its collagen, okay, that doesn't have any elasticity, what that's going to do is it's going to condition the hair and it's going to bring the hair also back to life. So not only are you chemically treating the hair, but you're also conditioning the hair at the same time. I have here our peroxide, okay? And before you use it, you know, you don't want to shake it like a mad person, okay? But, you know, you just want to make sure that you move it around a little bit, okay? Number two, it has a beautiful smell. And I'm going to come around, okay? So you guys can smell this, okay? It smells very good. You could eat it, but you shouldn't. It's not tequila.
Can we get high?
If you smell it long enough, yes. You want me to get 40 volume for you?
Go ahead. How many volume is this?
This is 20 volume, I think. So you have those clients that are very sensitive to color, or they itch a little bit. No matter what volume you put them, they kind of like itch a little bit, okay? This is the perfect color for them. Because not only does it have the conditionings in them and the enzyme, we also offer our finish, first and finish, which is our oil that you can add to the color. And this has collagen in it. So collagen, we know, is like the Botox, right? Mm-hmm. So what that does is that collagen is going to make the hair nice and plump, especially hair that's been overprocessed. You know, the hair that double, triple processed, that's very burnt and fried out. What that's going to do is that's going to plump that hair back up again, and it's going to give it elasticity. The elasticity is able for the hair to stretch and return to its natural position. So a few drops of this in your lightener or in your color, it's going to keep it from overprocessing. It's going to help the color process. For those girls that are very sensitive, they're going to enjoy this very much. There's a formula for the grays, if you guys didn't know. Anybody know the formula for the grays? Okay, usually what they say. If I have my client, which is 6.32, this is my color at 100%. Perfect color. Okay? And let's say I have what I call a gray invasion by 50%. 50% gray invasion. My color is not perfect anymore, right? Now my perfect is at 6.3. My 6.32 is at 50% because my gray invasion, right? My gray invasion took the strength out of it, right? So ever notice when clients, they do their hair at home and they want to come in, they say, look, I need something that's very resistant. My hair is very resistant. I need to cover my grays. And you actually see grays that are camouflaged, and they say that the color didn't work. That's not actually the color that didn't work. That's a fact of formulation. The formulation is off, okay? Mm-hmm. So what happens is you have to make sure that you add and fill. Remember, you need all three primary colors, right? In order to fill, red and white make pink. So you have to fill the shaft before you put the color inside. So this is how, when you have a client that has gray camouflage, when they have camouflage color, it's because there's an absence of natural in the hair. So you have to add natural to your target color. So your target level is 6, because that's your level, right? Mm-hmm. So if I have a gray invasion of 50%, I need to add 50% of my target level, and that's going to be 6N, right? Or 6 natural. In this case, let's say anything over 25%, like we said, we do a 1-in-1 ratio. So actually, what we need to do is change this to 75. I don't want to confuse you too much, right? But we're only going to add 25% of the natural because we're working 1-in-1, right? Does that make sense?
Yes.
When we're working 1-in-1, anything over 25, our ratio is 1-in-1. And if it's over 50, we want to add a little bit of natural into the hair. Now we're going to go into the Lumetrix, okay? Now, if you open your sheet, and for my Latinas, this
yes.
is Spanish also, page step A. The first thing that we need to know is our three amigos, okay? Not the movie. Everybody remember the movie, The Three Amigos?
Yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Remember?
Yes.
Okay.
Pistola.
So, okay? She's funny. Three amigos is our texture, our density, and our porosity. So texture has to do with the diameter of the hair. Is it fine? Is it medium? Is it coarse? The first thing to analyze and to understand when we're choosing our peroxides, right, is what the texture of the hair is. If the texture is very big, you need something strong, right? If the texture is very fine, you need something less, very easy. Actually, the density is how much hair per square inch. So the density is a factor because if I'm working with hair and I'm doing chemicals, I got to know where the hell I'm going to start and how long it's going to take me to put it in. Because as soon as I put in the color, as soon as it's going to work. Okay? So we want to make sure that whenever we're working with coarse, dense hair, we want to begin in the most resistant area. And the most resistant area is where?
In the back.
Beautiful. For some people, the grays, the perimeter is very resistant. Porosity is how the hair is able to absorb the color. All of these three different things are very important because they're gonna tell you how much is your volume, how much time you're gonna leave it on, okay? And what type of hair that you're working with so you don't overprocess the hair. Does that make sense? So the first thing is, when we're looking at step A, choose your shade. You wanna choose your shade. It's the first thing. So Lumetrix is a 2-in-1 lightening and color product allowing for up to 5 levels of lift. This is that Lumetrix was designed for tinted colored hair. So if you have a client that comes into the salon right now, mm-hmm. right, that has black hair, but under the black hair is already decolorized hair that's at level 6 or 7. In order for me to take that client and do some highlights on that client, especially black is never gonna happen. Black, you might get lucky. If it's box color black, forget about it. You need a color remover, Okay, because sometimes when you're putting lightener on black hair, what happens? Lightener is not designed to remove color. Lightener is like sandpaper. Sometimes we can get away with it, it'll scratch it out a little bit, but we're processing the hair. So even though it's still black, underneath it's getting decolorized and it's ripping the hair apart, okay? So when those clients come into the salon, and I have a girl that has black hair who wants red highlights or violet highlights, it's not gonna happen. It might not happen. I can put it through two color processes and I still won't get where I need to be. It could happen. Sometimes it can, sometimes it can. Sometimes we can get away with it, sometimes we can't. It all depends, okay? So when I'm working with that color, if that client comes into the salon, and I'm a guy who loves to work with numbers, okay? Anybody has a calculator here? Anybody with a calculator? Help me out for a second, okay? If I have a client that comes in that has black hair, black artificial colored hair, tinted hair, box color hair, okay? And underneath is level 6, okay? And I want to make the black into orange, beautiful orange highlights, all right? What's the first step that you guys would do? You have to bleach it, okay? Then after you bleach it, what do you have to do? It might not come up. You might have to do it twice. And then you do it again.
Yes.
And then again, because it didn't come up the first time, you put it under the dryer.
Yes.
Right? And then let's say you reach more or less where you want to reach. Now, mm-hmm. Now you have to add the color.
Yes.
Right? So how many products did you use?
Three.
Three products. In 1 hour, right, you use three products. And you're gonna charge her $100. And you know what? That's very fair. When you say that's fair, if you're using three products, you use three products. So how much product did you waste? You waste about $40 plus an hour time. Mm-hmm. With the Lumetrix, the average time is anywhere from 15 to a half an hour, right? And what it does is it's gonna break through the collar, okay? It will actually, if you're level 6 underneath, well, you can use a sweet potato if you want to do the orange, or you can do a red if it's underneath a 5, a level 5, a level 6, or a level 7. So I use one product, I took 30 minutes, right? I didn't do all the damage that I did with the double processing and then the color, right? So my hair condition is going to be a little bit better, right? And you know what I'm going to charge? I'm gonna charge the same money.
Same?
I'm gonna charge the same amount of money. But you know what else I did? I freed myself for 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. If I did one process, right, for one person in 1.5 hour, and it's $45 that I made extra, right, because I freed up a half an hour, 45 times 5, $225. Can you times that by 52? Because there's 52 weeks in a year. And that's only if you're working 5 days. How much is that?
$11,700.
How much?
$11,700.
$11,700? When you're lifting naturally with lightener, you're gonna be going through these stages. Mm-hmm. Okay? So if I want red from the Lumetrix line, right? And I'm working with natural color, I wanna be around here. I wanna be around this family. Right, because this is the family that I need to be in, okay? If I'm working with violet, I want to be in this family, okay, for violet. If I'm working with the beige or the gold or the coppers, right, I want to be kind of like in this family. So you see, as you're going up through the levels, when you know where your base is and where you are, that's how you understand if you can use the colors. So for example, we already said what the blue does, right? We said the blue, in order to get this blue, you gotta be at least at a level 9 or a level 10, right? Or if you want a nice clean color or a nice clean level, you can use it at level 1 and bring it to level 5, and that'll control your reds and you have a nice pigment, right? If I use this blue on level 6 or level 7, what color am I gonna get? Like a green. So people say, no, this didn't work. No, this worked. You didn't work. Because remember, color is a choice that you made, not a mistake, it's a choice. Color takes about 1 or 2 times, or maybe 3 times. As long as you're in the era, you're okay. If you're shooting for level 6 and you get level 5 or level 7, you're in the area, that's okay. The next time you come, you'll add a little bit or you take away a little bit. You balance the color. But if you're shooting for level 7 and you get level 3 or you're at level 10, you got a problem. 7 out of 10 colorists 7 out of 10 colors are uncomfortable with color. Yet they're the most popular, the most in demand, and they make the most money. Since she's at a level 5, or a level 3, I want to use that blue to control all my reds. So as I get to level 7, I'll probably be able to match her up, or if not, get her really close. And then from there, I'll put another formula on top of that. When you're working with levels that are extremely far apart, especially if they're over five levels, because anything over 5 levels, right, 40 volume is not gonna happen. So we can introduce our perfect white. Our perfect white will lift you up all the way up to almost 7 levels. Does it lift 7 levels all the time? No, it depends on what? Our 3 amigos, right? Our texture, our density, and our porosity, okay? So here we have the Super Lightening Plus, okay? And this is the blue lightener, right? And the blue lightener you can use on the scalp. And the reason why it'll reach 7 levels or close to it, because it's controlling the orange tones. When you're working from dark all the way up to the higher levels. And we also have the Perfect White, which is our Super Lightening Cream Bleach, okay? Or Cream Lightener. See, sometimes I get confused myself. Okay, and same purpose. Cream lightener works very, very easy. 1 to 2 parts, you know, where every scoop is 2 ounces, or 1 to 2 ratio on this, is usually used off the scalp with this one and on the scalp for this one. Okay.
Es este, pero él quiere probar como este o este.
The ratio, everybody remember? Now the key to this is heat, okay? You wanna make sure that you're not under a vent or anything, so you wanna make sure that it's processing well. If you put them under the dryer, because this works pretty quick, it could probably get away from you, so you just gotta let it work. Be careful.
This is the Ultra Voice, so 20 and 22.
So what I'm gonna be utilizing today is I'm gonna be utilizing the transparent strips. The great thing about this is that number one, it's transparent, okay? Number two, it keeps the moisture in, it doesn't dry out the hair like the foil. And number three, it's reusable, okay? You can reuse this. So if you're doing highlights in the salon and they're red or violet or orange, you're able to see your process. And especially if you have colors in it, because when people walk into the salon, they're like, oh wow, what's that? You know, if it has foils in it, nobody's excited. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna close this, just like this, right? So if I had an aluminum foil, I would just close this and that's it, okay? But with this also, I could move this over to the other side and open it, and sometimes we don't get on the other side, okay? We're gonna let that go over there. Let me show you guys something else really quick. Anybody do ombres? This is a little flash card with Velcro, right? So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put this all the way at the root of the hair, right? And I'm gonna put the teeth part on top, okay? I'm gonna bring this down all the way to the end. I'm gonna come in the middle. I'm gonna touch a piece in the middle, like right here. And then I'm gonna highlight that. That's for my ombre.
You wanna be able to watch this because it works fast. So the thing is, you need to babysit this. You need to watch this.